What's going on, guys? TBF Gaming, welcome back to Dark and Light. So check it out, guys. We're taking our two birds back to our main base right now. We did not make it back with the Kibo, so that's why we're not back at base already with the Kibo. We had to come back. I've been killed about six times today. We lost most of our gear. I bought a bunch more in town, but we're out again. We're pretty much, I've got a few bare bones stuff, not really a lot with us now, and we're just headed back to base. It really bummed out because we lost our Kibo. It was a level 110, 120, whatever it was that we tamed, but we met an elite griffin. So there's these things called elite griffins, which are just like those griffins, but they glow and they wreck you in one shot. So we ran into that. It was not fun. It was not pretty. And now we have no Kibo. So looks like we're going to go looking for a Kibo again over the next couple days, but that's fine. We kind of understand how to tame them now. And now that we're kind of airborne, I can actually find them fairly easy. You can see down here. They're in some pretty interesting places, so it would be possible to come down. There's 108. Alright, so there's 108, so it's definitely possible to come down here and actually find them and actually get us a decent level 1 so we can get them tamed up. Let's make sure our stamina is good to go as we head back to the house over here. Now, I always get it mixed up, but it's either, I think it's this hill right here is the one that we've actually built on this time. It's definitely a lot safer than the other areas that we've started in, but it's still down to the south of it, or down to the north of it, I should say, is still some pretty bad hombres, but we're kind of in a central location to build stuff, but we're told that we should build over here. There's like a lake area over in this direction that apparently is pretty safe, or maybe it's that lake there. I'm not 100% sure, but I don't know. This map definitely confuses us quite a bit, but the only time we know where we're at is when we die. Which luckily I've done a lot lately, so I have a better idea of where everything here is. I didn't realize over there where we were just now is actually further south than where our current house is, so that's kind of a new thing. Yeah, so this is our hill right here. This one is actually works out really, really well. It's got some decent supplies on it, and it's kind of central to everything, so we can start exploring. But today is going to be about tames. Today we got to get some tames going. We're going to get our griffin back and hopefully level up a little bit so we can get a griffin saddle, but it's super low level griffin. He's what level is he? Level 6. Pretty much as close to the lowest level as you can get in this game. But it's still a griffin. At least we have one. And then our Baroon is not bad. Level 77. Not great, but definitely better than nothing. But there are griffins everywhere, and they're fairly easy to tame as long as you don't run into multiple ones. So we're going to go out and actually try again. To get a little bit better level 1 here in a little bit. We're also going to go for another Kibo. We'll do that off camera so you guys don't have to sit through that again, because you basically saw that for the entire last episode. We had a fail and then finally got our success, so it happens. Alright, we should see our base build in here in just a second. I think we're not lost. Hold on, where is it? Where's home sweet home? You see everything kind of building in slowly. There it is. There we go. Alright. So not bad. We got our little mini base build over here. It's got a decent look to it. Better than our typical square build. We still got some work to do that we got to finish up on the inside and the outside. We did buy something in town that's pretty cool. If I still have it. I know we died so many times. I may have lost that as well. Alright. Let's get ourselves landed here. Let's tell you to stop following. Oh, no. Not trying to get anybody's inventory. Okay, let me go. Let me go. There we go. Alright, make sure no one's following. Look at that. That dude is really, really cool, though. Alright, so we did get one other thing in town here. This is called a spell generator. I have no clue what it is, but it was available to buy, and it wasn't that expensive, so I figured, why not? Okay. Let's see what it is. I have literally no idea. No? 100% not sure how that works. Alright, spell generator. I really don't know. Oh, wait a minute. Do we put a... Hold on. Do we put like a specific spell inside of there? Yep. Completely not sure. I'm going to have to do some research on that one. No big deal. Alright. So, alright guys. Back at base. I got to get a few things crafted up. Some armor and some other stuff. Get our forges and stuff going since we were gone for quite a while. And kind of see where we're at supply-wise. So give me a few minutes to get that going, and then we'll be back. All right, I've died 4 or 5 times trying to get this guy down. He's finally down. Check this out. We've got our first Wyvern down. It took forever. We've died from Griffin attack. We've died from the giant rock monster attack. You can see down the beach there, I've actually been building things to try to trap these guys. Let me show you. See that little structure down there? I've been trying to trap these guys, but we couldn't get it. So this guy, we've been following around for a couple hours trying to get him down, but he's finally down. I think this is what they eat. I can't remember for sure. So we're just going to give him everything. In fact, I'll give him the good stuff. There we go. And he's been down for a minute because we had to come back over here from our actual base over there. Okay. Can I climb? So I can't ride you yet. Okay. All right. Now we got to get this guy back to base without dying. That's the hard part. But base is right there. It's right on top of the hill. We just got to go to the right, and there's a little path that we can make it up. So there we go. First Wyvern. I'll meet you guys back at base when we can actually test this guy out. All right, guys. So we got him back up to base. We also got a couple of things in between episodes here, in between recording, because we've already downed one of these on camera. So we just got a couple more low-level ones. Really low-level. Like this was a level 4. This was a level 20-something, 20 or 24. And then we got another Kibo. Decently high level here. This guy started at a 1... either 108 or 100, something like that. And he's up to 170. In fact, we got any more levels? Not yet. We'll take him out. We actually took him out and did a little bit of leveling, gathering as many resources as we can, which really helps out because check this out. Now we have so much stuff going on the forge. We are set for a long time here. Let's keep that going. We've been disconnected in between doing this stuff. And on single player, when you get disconnected, everything stops making. So every time we get back on, we have to restart everything. Yeah, we've been disconnected 3 or 4 times. So I cannot equip a saddle yet on this guy. Starting stats, really low. 300 health, 149 attack. Focus, 720, who cares. Stamina, 480. It seems like he's really fast. When he was following us back up the hill, he was flying around us almost as fast as the Griffin. So I have to see which one is actually better between those. So the only really good tame we have so far is the Kibo, 170. And the boar is not bad. Our little boar buddy's not too bad. All right. So there you go. That's what we got going so far. So right now, I need to spend a little bit of time basically leveling up because... Hold on. I think the Wyvern saddle we can make. Let me see here. Riding? No, it's next. So we are at 29%. So I need to go harvest hides from fallen creatures, craft saddles, and tame creatures. So what I was going to do is look at which saddle is the cheapest to make. So we'll go like this and see which one. See, that's 35 hide. That's only 15 hide. Oh, but it takes fur. 40. No. It takes 30 hide. There you go. 25 hide. So far, the flat horn. That takes 30 hide. That only takes 15 hide. I'm thinking we're going to spam boar saddles. I want to see if this is going to work or not. So let's grab. I don't have a lot of stuff here, but we have enough to at least get rolling with it. We can always go down and start killing some more stuff here in a second. Get some more hide. Is that all the hide that I have? It might be. Oh, no. There we go. Okay, I got 2 stacks of hide. All right, and then we need... I think it was... Hold on, let me see. No, let's get out of here. Let's check this again. All right, so that's quite a few there. I need twine and wood. So twine and wood. We should have tons of twine on here. There we go. 1, 2... Get a little bit of wood. Okay. So I just need to go get some wood. Nope, we're good to go. Perfect. So basically, I'm just going to spam saddle like crazy. The actual boar saddle. Alright, so I can craft 21. This is a huge waste of resources, but it should. Let's see if it does. It should level me up a little bit on riding. Okay, we'll wait till it makes the first one and see what happens. Please work, because I really, really need to level this up. So there's 30%. So how much is it per? So 30%. How much more here? 31%. Oh, God, I got to make 70 of these. Okay. All right, I guess I'm going to spend some time making about 70 saddles. I'll be back in quite a while. All right, we're finally on the last few getting made here, the boar saddles. We made somewhere around 70 or 80 boar saddles. I don't even know anymore. We've been doing this forever, the entire night. Pretty much had to go out and get hide 2 more times, and we had to go out and get wood 2 or 3 more times. And then now we're pretty much good to go. We should hit 100% here in just a second, and then we will clear the queue. There we go, clear the queue. So it'll make 1 more, and then we're good to go. So now we can do the Wyvern saddle. That's the only reason we sat there and did this for so long. Look at these. So we're going to keep a few. I've already dropped a ridiculous amount. We're just continuing to drop them. Oh, no. Did I drop something important? I'm not sure. All right, drop, 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 drop. Bam. There we go. All right, now, the Wyvern saddle, I'm not sure. Is that on us or on the thing? Okay, so for that one, I need 420 hide, 600 twine, 250 fur, and 30 copper. So we have the copper. All right. So let's take this. We'll split it a couple times. All right. Split one more time. There we go. Okay. So because we have a super short memory, what else was it? Wyvern. So we're good on the copper. 250 of the fur. I don't know that we have that. Man, we might have to go out and look for that. Let's see. Oh, no, no, we got it. 1, 2, 300 of that. All right. There we go. Oh, are we good? We've got it all. Here we go. Bam, we're getting a wyvern saddle crafted up. Yes. All right. Let's go ahead and empty out our other stuff while we're waiting for that. I'm going to empty all this stuff out. Put our hide and stuff over here. So I'm trying to get a little bit of organization going in here so we at least know where some of the stuff is. All the animal stuff's going to go over here. Yep, it can all go in here. We'll cook some more up later. We're doing fine on cooked food. All right. Throw our apples here because we like doing this little apple pie thing. There we go. Yeah, I really like doing the apple pies. Really cool. Makes it super easy. All right, so we'll craft a bunch of that up. And we'll craft a bunch of that up. There we go. It's a thing. All right, so that's going. Let's drop some more of this stuff because I know I'm going to be overweight. Like I said, we went out and got wood and everything else a bunch of times, so we're definitely going to be overweight for the Wyvern. He does not have good stats. But he should be super, super amazing. Okay. That should be good enough. Let's find out. Here we go. Oh, man. Here we go. Wyvern level 24. Super low level. Don't even care. Here we go. First flight. They're so loud when they walk. Check this guy out. All right, let's do it. Oh, these guys are so much faster than the Barunda. Let's keep an eye on his stamina, see how he does. I feel like this finally opens up the entire map. Look at this. Now we can really, really get to the other places in the map, like quickly, somewhat quickly now. Flying with the Barunda took forever and a day. Oh man. Now these guys don't have much for attack. They have such low health. I really can't get attacked by anything without dying, so we gotta be careful. What do we got? Yeah. What is this place? Okay. Kind of a cool little place. Can you build on places like this? I probably dropped all my stuff, so I can't test it out, but I would like to know if you can build on something like this. It'd be kind of a cool place to, you know, build around. Kind of a little prefab. Look at that. It's like ready to be built on. Okay, I need to know if I can build on here. This is usually how we die. So be ready for us to lose our wyvern right now. Alright, let's see. This is literally always where we die. Oh, no. My bad. We're switching the wrong things here. There we go. And a little bit of that. Alright, we just have to test it out real quick. Can I build down here? Close to it. We can. Can I build on top of it? Let's find out. Land right here. And then we'll see if we can build just right here on top. Okay, we can't build on top of it. Okay. So no to building on top of it, but we can at least build, you know, down inside of it. That's kind of cool. Let's just go all the way down. Just double check. Please don't find anything bad down here. Yeah, I mean, you can build pretty much anywhere around it. Kind of inside of it, sort of. Yeah, sure enough, look at that. We can actually build in there. We might have to think about that later. All right, let's get back up top before something bad happens. We'll do a little more exploring with this brand new wyvern. This guy is amazing. Yeah, I wish that we would record a little bit more of actually catching him, but it was pretty much a disaster. It took so many times, and I died so many times. It got a little frustrating. And then we downed him. We actually knocked him down. We died, and then I paused the game. I walked away for a minute, came back, and the game had crashed on me. So we're having a lot of bad luck with the game crashing on us. Check this area out. Holy cow. Oh, buddy. Oh, check this area out. You know what? I think the first time we ever played this game, this is on a multiplayer server, this is close to where our base was. It was definitely in an area like this. If there's like little like blue glowing things over here in the middle, then I know we're in the right area. Let's do some dropping. We got lots of stuff here, don't we? Drop that, drop that, 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 and then all of that crap. This guy probably needs some meat. I should really get this guy some meat, shouldn't I? Yeah, he's about halfway down. Let's see. You want some regular food, man? Let's do this. See if you want some of the good stuff. You want to eat that? There you go. I can give you half this. Check this out. There we go. Let you eat good. Yeah, we've definitely been here before. Over here is like Goblin Central over here somewhere. And then in the center, there's like these little glowing area. Yep, there it is. There it is. Yeah, we've definitely been here before. This is a really cool area. There's the Nidhogg? I don't know what you call those. We'll definitely come back and try and tame one of those soon. Yeah, check this area out. Oh, buddy. Yeah, this is Panther Central. Now, kind of similar to how we're failing pretty much all the time now. Back then it was Panthers. We would fail on Panthers once every 5 minutes. Yeah, this is a really cool area. Oh, man. So much of the map is open now. Look at this. It's just amazing. Look at that. Oh, good. When we go into this mode, it mutes out the music. That's good to know. All right. We should probably get a little bit of picture action, huh? There we go. Get a little bit of sweet picture action for the thumbnail. That's what I'm talking about. All right. We probably won't go too much further. I would like to check out the town right here. I always like to check out these little towns, see if there's anything cool in it. Okay, so nothing really with that one. Oh, we gotta land. Anything bad? Oh, there's wolves over there. Stay away, wolf. They have really, really high aggro range. Same with the panthers. They see you from so far away. Yeah, there's our panther buddies. This guy's so fast. So usually what happens now, just like I say every episode, usually what happens now when we actually finally tame something, this is usually where we die. Usually now we get attacked by something crazy, and then we don't make it back to base with our super new amazing tame. Alright, let's get up here. Come on. Oh, check this place out. Okay. Let's be really careful. I am going to have to learn like a better way to tame these wyverns, because this was really hard for a low level one. I'm not even sure how you do a high level. Oh, wow. What is this? What in the world? What is that? Oh, man. I'm afraid to like... Oh, nope. We're not messing with the griffin today. I want to go see what that magic thing is, but I feel like if I walk through, I'll die. Let's just keep going. Oh, my God. What is this? Oh, this is new. Oh, this is new and super ominous. Check this out. All right, let's get over here and land just for a second before the griffin gets us. See, look how long their aggro range is. You've been following me forever. They do not lose interest very often. All right, check this out. Oh, buddy. Oh, man. We're going to have to check this out. What is this? Oh, wait a minute. This is the dwarf town. We've never actually been here. I think I've rolled a lot of characters, but I don't think I've ever rolled a dwarf. I've done humans, and I've done elf, obviously, which is what we are now. Look at this place. The dwarven city. Very cool, man. This place is really cool looking. Look at that. Look at this. All right, I assume they attacked me, so we got to be careful here. Yeah, they attack. And we got super low level health, so let's not fight. Look at that. Yeah, buddy. Oh, wait, I hear like a music. Listen to that. It's got like the epic music. Very like Ark versus like Lord of the Rings. Like this game is such a cool combination of so many things. Ooh, look at that. I mean, I guess we kind of need to look around in here. Oh, this looks just like the Wyvern dens in Ark, but obviously the dwarves live here. Very, very cool. All right, let's jump out of here. That is super amazing. I like it. All right. Is this another spot down here? Oh, it is. Look at this. Little throne room. Wow. You got all the magma underneath there. They did a phenomenal job on this map. I know every single episode I've been saying something similar to that. The game has its problems. The game has its glitches. The game has definite issues. But the map is amazing. All right. Let's see how we're doing here. All right. Now, where in the world is our base? So now it's the struggle to figure out where we're heading back to. With the fog, we're not 100% sure. All right, let's go down just a little bit. We should be able to see. Okay, so we got to go back towards the tree. There we go. Oh, man. All right, guys. Hey, so it might end up being kind of a short episode. It wasn't a short episode for me. I've been playing for several hours in a row just with all the problems we've been having and how many between the glitches in the game and the actual me dying over and over and over again. It has been a long afternoon. So we're going to end it here. I'm going to fly back to base. I am not going to go anywhere else. We're going to fly straight back to base, land, and log off for the day so we don't lose our Wyvern. Really excited to try this guy a little bit more and actually use him to maybe help pick things up. I don't know. We'll have to see if we can get a bunch of sheep together. We need to make sure our fur game is on point. And then see what we can do the next episode. Maybe we'll go after, come over, try one of these Nidhogs, Nighthogs, whatever they're called. I know there's a spell we can use to help slow them down, so maybe we can tame them. All right, guys. Make sure you guys like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next episode of Dark and Light. Hopefully with a little more success and a little bit less failure.